Hello guys, welcome back. Now some of you requested me to make a video about all my aquarium store. So I'm starting it. This is my planter tank and you can see my carpeting atom is becoming successful once I use the CO2 diffuser kit. So the do-it-yourself CO2 diffuser kit worked for me, and I would suggest that if you want a healthy planted aquarium like this one, use the cheap do-it-yourself CO2 kit. This is my hang-on filter and also the light whose intensity can be changed. This is my golden alligator. You might know it if you have watched my previous videos. I have kept it in the planted aquarium for cleaning purpose, and this alligator does the cleaning very effectively. After keeping it, I have never seen an algae in my planted aquarium. Maybe the alligator is the reason, or maybe the climate may be the reason, but definitely there is a change after keeping this fish. Now this is my do-it-yourself CO2 diffuser kit, and after using it, as I told earlier, there was certainly a change. The high CO2 required carpeting plants are growing up, but this CO2 diffuser kit is not automated. I have to shut down it every time in the morning, so I am trying to make it automatic. So in the upcoming videos, you can see the videos about making it automatic. Now this is my discus tank. I am maintaining it pretty well, doing weekly water change and cleaning the dirts and debris on weekly basis. My fishes are looking healthy and vibrant in their colors. This one is a wild caught. This is sun-red discus. One of the exciting thing about this discus fish aquarium is that two of the discus have become paired, and one of the discus is laying egg. I don't know about the other discus has fertilized it or not. You can see that there is some eggs on the rock. So if the fries are coming out, then definitely these two are pairs. Now the bad thing is that these discus are eating their eggs. So every time I see in the morning, the eggs are gone. This is their third attempt of laying eggs, so I have to do something about it. The best thing is that the egg lid should be covered. I have a mesh net like this one, so I will cut it out and try to put around the laid eggs. Now this is the cutout piece. Now I try to fix it inside the aquarium somewhere around near to the laid eggs, so that nobody can eat the eggs. So far it is looking good. I am certainly interested to see the fries coming out from that eggs. I don't know about it, whether it is fertilized or not. So this discus aquarium needs plants and the wood decors that I will be adding in the future. Now moving on, this is my turtle aquarium, and I have a turtle that is about 2 years old, and it has grown to very large size. So this turtle aquarium needs a canister filter, or I should remove this turtle and make a pond for it so that the water don't get dirty quickly. So after keeping this turtle in this small aquarium, the water gets dirty in about half a week. So that is very bad thing. So I should start the project of building a pond for the turtle but it requires too much money. The pond liners cost about 20,000 rupees, and then rocks are required, then pond filters are required. So if you can help me, check the links in the video description. You can crowdfund me so that I can make this turtle pond very soon. Now next is my small cylindrical beta tank that I recently built. I am keeping a male beta in it and use some green plants in it along with wood decors. So it is looking very good. I will be certainly removing the beta from this tank and I will be adding it to a small filtered attached tank for spawning and for breeding the beta. I also have the female in the discus tank. So this is the male beta. It is looking very beautiful with the red fins and blue body. The cylindrical shape and the plants are looking very beautiful for this tank, but the bad thing is that there is no filter. I shouldn't be keeping this beta fish. Most of you people agree over it. So I will be removing this beta and I will add to a filter attached small nano aquarium. So stay tuned for that video. It will be uploaded very soon. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe now for watching my upcoming videos. This is my spare aquarium. I have no idea with this aquarium. I may be using it for growing Java moss and aquatic plants and also for keeping small sized fishes. Now the last one is my outdoor lotus aquarium. I am trying to clean the lotus aquarium after many months. Now the good thing about this lotus aquarium is that I planted some plant about few months back and now it has grown like crazy. So there is large amount of plants available for me for keeping in other aquariums. So I don't need to buy the aquatic plants. And also I put some platys in this tank and now there are about 20 to 30 platys. So they have multiplied a lot. So I can sell those platys and maybe I should keep the beta fishes in this tank. If you want me to do something about this lotus aquarium, please comment it in the comment section and I will follow it. Also, if you want to see any other video of your own interest, please comment it and I will certainly take note of it. So there you can see some platys, about 4 of them are coming to the surface. I have done cleaning this lotus aquarium. Now I will add water back to this aquarium. So there it is. I'm filling up the aquarium. Bad thing is that this aquarium don't have any filter. If there was a filter, then this green water would have gone and the fishes would have been quite visible. I have some solar panel and batteries and also controllers, so I could make a power source for this lotus aquarium outside my home so that I could attach a filter or water fountains for this aquarium. It would have been very cool. So that's all about the tour of all my aquariums. What would have happened to the eggs that were laid by the discus? Also, what all carpeting plants I will be adding in my planted aquariums. Stay tuned for the upcoming videos. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe, like and share this video to your friends. Until next time, bye to all and take care. Thanks for watching.